Aya.
Oyo ni dira wa kuno. Ubo yenda ngalirikia, ubo yenda ngalirikia. Oba, wanashibaje. Ali ya uko kukumpia.
Ono yaje magana no we.
Mana ndo.
Eh, duzi we mwaje mwako mawo. Awo we mwako mazeni tu. So,
Okay, so many I bed. What go where you can? Okuru card creeping, so you can.
What is that one? Mwenye sana lukele kishari wapama.
Amen. This is the seat.
Shaba kupa.
Tukwele hidi kitera binu yipecho.
Ana bedu kuru oro makuwete dingati kitera.
Mimi yupo sio makawari.
Atunda kasi.
Makawari peta.
Bini moja ubini. Peta ndiyo moja ubini nikuoro. Ana kanya la bini salamu toku pole. Aya ni mama kubadili. Ate koro kutundumbera mateke kama wakati rangi. Kiri jiji juto kiri na kasi sika ingo wakati haruwa ni. Ivi ndiyo njia sano kuni ndiyo. Adi yeleni chipa magomo sa.
This is so good.
Men a Monday Nedo, move your door when they buy the tea autumn.
Mate,
there are little money I could put up in the tunnels and the people might be a bit of meat. And then I knew the month and I woke up so merrily.
Men of the matter. So overcut the two hung on.
In a little matter, you can have to be some of the money which I could walk. They must have a cup of ginger food. I'm not going to be able to do it.
So in African homestead, you will always find either medicinal plants or fruits or foods, anything. For example, this is avocado tree. This is passion fruit. You can see there is passion fruit even there. This is guaguas. Here. There is some there. This guaguas. We just ate popo. You will also find mango. That's a mango tree. So basically, the passion fruit is passion fruit is on that big tree. I don't know even which tree is that one. Then cassava, and then of course those are coffee, and these are banana. This here again is passion fruit. And of course, banana again. The other side, there is again guagua tree. And of course, fene, jackfruit. This is avocado. Then in Tula. This particular plant here, in all African homes, it is there. I don't know how they call it in English, but in Dipadola it's called Musolua. In Luganda, it's called Musambia. In Igbo, it's called Ogilisi. It's a very powerful medicine. It is one of the sacred trees, by the way. It's a very, very powerful medicine. You can search about it in Google or anywhere. This is yam. Basically, if the other fene tree is not having fene, you look for another one. If the other avocado tree is not having avocado, you come to another. So there you can find more than 5 or even 10 avocado tree. And the surprising thing here is that they don't sell it. It's just for eating. This is also avocado, that's fene. Fene is jackfruit, that's how we call it. In fact, in the whole Uganda, all languages, either Nilotics, Bantu, wherever group it might be, jackfruit is called fene. Comment below if you also call it in your language as fene. But in the whole Uganda, I don't know about other countries. Either Lusoga, Luganda, Acholi, Lang, anyhow, Karamojong, they call it fene, jackfruit. This one is guaguas, of course. And then, of course, popo.
papaya.
Some people call it papaya. So this is another guaguas coming in. We also do have here this thing. We eat it, but I don't know how they call it in English. But it brings out seeds. Its seeds are like this. We eat it. I've forgotten it even though they call it in our language, but I remember we eat it. It's like beans. And then of course the same place, the same plant. I've forgotten its name in English. Forgotten its name in some starts with the one Namat, something like that, but it's a scientific name. So every African home has this tree. Only those who know it's sacred. But it is a very, very powerful medicine. And of course, passion fruit. You see? The same thing is here. Now ask yourself, why is it that it is there everywhere? God knows how to place things in a strategic place for a specific purpose. This thing here. Now here there is more guaguas than any other place. Guaguas. There are too many. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, 3. The others are avocado and coffee. But deep inside there are too many. And mango. Over here, mangoes are even ripe. These are improved mangoes. These are not local mangoes. And this is season for mango, by the way. Whenever you are in the bush and then you accidentally, maybe something cuts you. If you know blackjack, you see, God is so wise. Whenever you have issues, there is medicine near you, readily near you. If you can't go to the hospital immediately, just get blackjack alone and just squeeze the juice and put in your wound. And then if the wound is too serious, you use this, you mix this. We call it kapanga in my local language. I think even in Uganda it's called kapanga. You mix this with blackjack and then you put in the wound. It heals so fast. Within, once you put, first of all, the use of blackjack, it does two things. Number one, it stops blood flow. Because if, immediately when you cut yourself, there is excess blood flow. Then, after the blood is no longer flowing, it also improves clotting, like that pit, that place. It heals very, very fast. If the wound is small, even the following day, you will not feel pain, and you will be fine. Now, if it is too serious, you mix blackjack and this kapang, and you put in the wound. However big the wound is, for as long as blood can stop coming out, you're already fine. It's not just first aid, but it is real medicine. So here we have very many plants we use for, we call them boundary trees. This is Broa, this one. This is Broa, this is a boundary tree. It has, if you pluck this, it will bring out some sort of milk. Yeah, it's the one. You see? Doesn't take time before you notice that milky something. This is called Broa. This Broa. Then that one we call it Openg. They are all boundary trees. Whenever they are making a boundary, it's a natural way how they used to make boundaries. Kole me megeche me pipe mapi. Tete pipe openga. This is a water pipe. Actually, the lake is Nyanja Kiborgeka. The Lake Victoria is just somewhere that side. It's not far. I think this person, there's one rich man here who decided to get water direct from Lake Victoria, either for I don't know. Maybe for home use or whatever reason he needs the water for.